Yeah, hi there. This is tuxaha.com. Welcome on my video channel. When you are able to view this video on YouTube, Skylum has released their Lumina AI Update 2. As many manufacturers these days, also Skylum released a new update, an update for their Lumina AI program with two main new features or improved features and some features which are only minor improvement, but they make sense at their place. So let's take a look on the improvements, in this case for example the textures, and let's take a look at it on a desktop PC. Okay, I installed Lumina AI Update 2, just want to start it. And as you can see, I already added some images and some folders to the catalog. First of all, we want to look at a minor improvement in Lumina AI Update 2. And that is, for example, here, if we click here on that image, the info panel here downside in the right corner, which shows you the EXIF metadata all the time, even if you go to a full screen view of the image. The other minor improvement is if you go to the edit tab, and let's say for color, then you probably miss here the buttons for revert and deactivate the effect, but those buttons are only visible if you start to change settings here, like for example here changing the saturation, and then you see here the buttons for reverting, deactivating and adding a mask to the effect. Okay, that were the minor improvements. Let's go back to the catalog. Let's revert the adjustment I made, and maybe we take then, okay, we take one of this series here, go to the edit tab, or take a look at the templates first. That is rearranged so the templates have the same size, and also my templates and templates you might have well purchased will show up here under the templates for this photograph. Okay, let's go back to the edit tab, and now we go to the sky, go to sky selection. Oh, that's a pretty sunny day, so we might as well take a bright sky for this one. Oh, looks pretty good. As you can see here, inserted the sky, and if we go to the 100% view, you see here in the fine details that some of the settings are not accurate, and that you can hopefully fix with the mask refinement here with the fixed details ruler. Go all the way up, and the 100% view, there might be still some errors visible, but it's getting better. Okay, we go back. What's new here in the sky replacement 2 is that you have a vertical and horizontal offset where you can move the sky so it will fit more to the scene. You have to copy in the new sky. And maybe we go back to the catalog and I'll show you another example. Vertu original, maybe we go, let's say to this one here or to this one here, take that one, go back to edit, make a sky selection, like for example this one. Okay, and what Skylum has added or newly implemented in this sky replacement is the ability to add the reflection from the selected sky into a water surface like here, but it's not that much because there are is movement on the water surface. But if we check the vertical adjustment here, you can see that here the tonal equivalent will change too. So it might as well only work on flat water surface and not on a surface like this one here. What Skylum added newly here to the update 2, besides the other improvement, is if we go back to the edit tab, go to local masking, we now can add textures, and I downloaded textures from Skylum, really my world. And here we got a texture in a transparent PNG format. Let's take, for example, here the first canvas setting, and that is now transparently added to this image. Takes a little while. Now you can see here the first things from the texture image. Maybe we strengthen that a little bit so you can see the effect, like this one here. And now what you can do is place the texture just as you want. And what you can do, and that is pretty interesting, you can maybe, for example, add another one, load another texture file, but this time we don't load texture, we load a logo like this one. Go here to place the texture here, and first of all resize it so it will fit the final image. Like that. Place it down here in the corner. Okay, and that would be the effect with the texture and the logo inserted into your image. But that's not enough. You could now here define a template from these settings, from the texture and the adding of the colored logo, and apply this to your images as you like. As you could see, the major improvement is the sky replacement tool, which is now, first of all, is available in Luminar AI with the ability to generate fitting reflections on water. So the whole scene is more reliable or easy to believe that's an original photo. And the second improvement are the textures. The textures are mainly implemented as transparent PNG files, so you don't have to stick to the texture files. You could also add other photos or your own logo and things like that into the texture part of the program. And with this, you can add your logo and other graphics to your photographs as you like. And with this functions, as I showed you here in the example, you add your own logo into your images. The minor improvements like the info panel and the histogram are nice, but the histogram still has the error or the bug that if you go to the edit panel and the histogram is visible and you change anything like exposure or contrast in the picture which is relevant for the histogram, the histogram is updated only if you release the ruler. And that's, I think, still is a bug in Luminar AI. But maybe you want to tell me in the comments what you think about the Luminar AI update 2. The update, of course, for all of you, you have a license for Luminar AI, is free of charge and available for download now. If you don't have Luminar AI so far, you might as well download your server test version and judge yourself if Luminar is fitting your needs for your workflow on image processing. If you have any questions on that, you might as well place them in the comments or in the comments to the corresponding blog post. and I will try to answer them. And if this video was a little bit helpful to you, you might as well think about subscribing my channel, but then don't forget to hit the bell so you get a notification every time I upload a new video. Okay, that was my little review on Luminar AI Update 2. And all I have to say, till the next time, ciao, tux oche.